That was no easy task. They all stood looking from one road to another in perplexity. The paths radiated from the little clearing like the rays of the midday sun, and each path seemed like all the others. Files and the Rose Princess, who had by this time become good friends, advanced a little way along one of the roads and found that it was bordered by pretty wildflowers. "Why don't you ask the flowers to tell you the way?" he said to his companion.
"The flowers?" returned the princess, surprised at the question.
"Of course," said Files. "The field flowers must be second cousins to a rose princess, and I believe if you ask them, they will tell you." She looked more closely at the flowers. There were hundreds of white daisies, golden buttercups, bluebells, and daffodils growing by the roadside, and each flower head was firmly set upon its slender but stout stem. There were even a few wild roses scattered here and there, and perhaps it was the sight of these that gave the princess courage to ask the important question. She dropped to her knees, facing the flowers, and extended both her arms pleadingly toward them. "Tell me, pretty cousins," she said in her sweet, gentle voice, "which way will lead us to the kingdom of Ruggedo, the Gnome King?" At once all the stems bent gracefully to the right, and the flower heads nodded once, twice, thrice in that direction.
"That's it," cried Files joyfully. "Now we know the way."
Ozga rose to her feet and looked wonderingly at the field flowers, which had now resumed their upright position. "Was it the wind, do you think?" she asked in a low whisper.
"No, indeed," replied Files. "There is not a breath of wind stirring. But these lovely blossoms are indeed your cousins, and answered your question at once, as I knew they would."